Just a couple of notes on this job. First off, I had replaced this as part of a larger job of replacing the evaporator and the compressor. My compressor had seized, so when that happens, they highly recommend replacing the condenser just as a preventative measure in case it has been blocked up as a result of metal debris entering it from the seized compressor. I also replaced the dryer, of course, and most importantly, you can't do any of this work without properly evacuating the system first of all refrigerant. As you'll notice, when I start the job off, I realize it'll be a lot easier if I remove the upper radiator hose. So I had previously drained most of the coolant. And well, if you're gonna do the same thing to make your life easier, drain the coolant too. Hope this helps. I ran out of steam at the end and did not get good footage of the reinstallation, but really, hopefully you'll get the idea that this is a pretty straightforward job. Good luck.
All right, as part of this never-ending job, I've got to take, replace the condenser. So I'm going to pull the old one out now, which is really a pretty simple job. One, two, three, four, I think they're 12 mil bolts. And then disconnect the two rigid hoses that actually connect to the condenser. And then you've got two 10 mil bolts. To get rid of, and then you can pull it right out. I'm going to put 12 mil. Take this off anyway. So let's take that off now. I'm gonna take this off anyway for the job I'll be doing later. Pressure off that. That should be fine. That should be good enough. Now I got a zip tie there that I need to get rid of. Millimeter bolt here that I'll get with a swivel socket or a swivel wrench. It's going to be a lot easier if I take the battery out. Okay. battery out to get direct access to the bolt. Got it. Pliers and break that. Oh, so I just put a zip tie in instead of a bolt. So I'm just destroying the zip tie here. Bolts left. It's a 10. So you can see that the eyelet where I had the zip tie there, that had a 10 mil bolt, but I had to replace it with a zip tie, and on the other side, you can see the rubber grommets there, right here, where my finger's pointing. Hard to see that. Anyway, there are two rubber grommets there. That's where the 10 mil bolt goes. Once those two things are out, you can just pull the thing right out. Continuing to, I've removed I've removed the condenser and I've got a replacement condenser from the rec yard, and I'm just prepping to put it back in. I'm going to start by removing one of the AC hoses that's connected to the dryer, and I may actually just remove the dryer at this point just because that's the next step anyway for tomorrow. Two of the O-rings I'm going to replace, and that gives me a lot of room. I'm going to take off the high pressure hose from the dryer now. Pressure hose out of the way, like so. That'll allow me to take that dryer out. Two nuts on the outside. Take the dryer out. 10 mil nuts. Be able to just lift that dryer array out and plug it. There's a harness you need to unplug from it. That is a dryer. So I need to take this off, put it on the new dryer. I won't do that until I'm absolutely ready. Well, I can do this now, but the idea is you shouldn't expose the dryer to humidity. Okay, trick. The only trick to doing this is to make sure you don't damage the radiator on the way in. That's the biggest thing. Or the condenser for that matter. No, it's a lot easier to get in than it was to take out. Let's just sit in some slots down there. putting the 10 mil bolt back in.